www.spokedark.tv ภูมิใจนำเสนอ
Hello, you guys, and welcome back to another English episode of Mome Pa Pleun, and of course, this craziness right here. And this is a look inspired by Rita Ora, music video Body on Me with Chris Brown. This is pretty much what I would consider a chola look, which is like a Latin girl kind of look, and she pulled it off nicely, and I just love it the moment I saw it.You know, it took me a while to figure out what I'm gonna use to create this crazy lip color. So if you like it and want to try it, just keep on watching. So before we start, we want to prep our skin nicely. So I'm gonna start by using Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. I have been using this every day in many steps, actually. I use it before I apply anything on my face. I mean, after skincare, before primer, and then after foundation and concealer, before powder, and then after everything is done. So it's three steps altogether, not just a finishing spray, actually.The primer I'm using today is Makeup Forever Mattifying Primer. I find that this, in conjunction with this, works really well. Just use this for the whole face and use my finger to apply it. Focusing on my T-zone, it's not a silicone-like. It's very, I wouldn't want to say sticky, I would say tacky when you apply it. It doesn't glide on as smooth, but I mean, it kind of makes your foundation stick to it and it mattifies everything.So today I'm gonna try something more of like a first impression video as well. This is a Too Faced Born This Way foundation. I'm beautiful in my way. That's not. I pick up the color Light Beige. It's an undetectable medium to full coverage foundation with an oil-free formula. So it says it's infused with coconut water, alpine rose, and hyaluronic acid, which kind of helps moisturize your skin.And then brighten your skin up and also keep your face looking young. I don't even know how a foundation can promise so much. This doesn't have any SPF on them, so if you are going out during the day, just bear in mind that you have to wear an extra step of sunscreen, but I recommend you do that anyways, no matter if your foundation has an SPF or not. The reason that I pick up this color is because on the website it said it's for light to medium skin,with neutral to golden undertone, which should be a little tad bit darker than what I usually go for, but I just tan myself so you can see that my arm, my neck, and everything is like darker than my face. So I'm applying this using a beauty blender. I kinda was hoping that this is gonna be good because I heard nothing but great things about this foundation throughout the whole YouTube community. It sucks when you like,When you heard good things about something over the internet and you just like, oh my God, this is gonna be so good. And normally it's a fail because you feel like, oh, you hope so much that this stuff is gonna be so good. A lot of people said that you can either apply it with your finger, apply it with a brush, or a beauty blender. I think with different technique, you get different finishes out of it. I have been addicted to this little baby that I cannot live without it. If I don't have it, I'm gonna go buy a new one.That's what I normally do. With a little bit of concealer. Okay, it said it's a buildable medium to full coverage foundation. So we might as well just use this little thingy to cover some more spots. If it can do that, this is gonna be a winner. Oh yeah. As you can see a little bit earlier, I have hyperpigmentations and also a little bit of scarring going on, like post-acne scarring.Okay, no concealer whatsoever. Let's see how it stays during this whole process, because you know that like in the studio, we have a lot of lights going on. Somebody said, oh, you do a first impression video, but you don't really stay with it all day. How can you know that it's gonna stay on your face? If you come and look at the lights that I have in here, it's like you'd be standing in the sunlight for about an hour shooting a show. So if it melts, it just melts right in here, even though how much we blast the air condition. So I kind of know how the product is gonna work for me or not right away in the studio without spending a whole day with it. But of course, it's better if you go on your normal days and just do your normal things. Just before you buy, just go try. I have to use an under eye concealer just a bit. I'm using the Vise CC Concealer. This is a Japanese concealer, but I like the consistency. It's not too heavy. I just kind of dot it. I have really high hopes for this foundation and also the new Makeup Forever Ultra HD, which I'm gonna go get in the US and try it and see how it goes. It's a never-ending quest of a perfect foundation. Like, what is a perfect foundation, woman? So we're gonna set everything with powder, and dear God, I miss you. Laura Mercier Loose Setting Powder in Translucent with my beloved Shiseido Puff. Too Faced Shadow Insurance. Okay, we need to set this whole thing with a matte eyeshadow. So I'm gonna use the Naked Smoky palette. I'm gonna use the Combust color with my 3 Cosmetics brush. Set this whole thing so that we have more blendability. Is that a word? We are gonna go a little matte, but still, the focus, everything is gonna be the lips. I'm coming back to the Naked One palette because I find that I get the most out of my socket with these two color, my favorite, Naked and Buck. The reason that I had to use two is because I don't have a matte nude color. That was it. So I'm gonna use a Zoeva crease brush. Start with Naked, kind of lightly define my crease. I know that I have this mirror right here, which I'm not really using. I'm sorry about that. It's just like my eyesight has been bugging me a bit. Not going too crazy. The focus will be eyeliner and the lips. If you would like, you can add more. There's no rule to it. I was gonna do the hair too, but I don't think like that hair would work for me. It's only for Rita. And plus she's blonde and all that, so. Okay, and then I'm gonna add Buck, which is darker, the darker brown, into the crease using the tip of the brush. Because when you see a dome brush like this, if you work with it on the side, you get more space. But if you use the top, you get more of a focus area. And I go all the way in as well. But if you have a close set eyes where your eyes are very, you know, close and narrow right here, you try to focus your darker color outside instead of bringing all the way in. She has some sort of a nude pinkish light on the center of her eyes, so I'm just gonna use something from this palette as well. I'm gonna be changing my brush to a denser one and use both. I'm gonna mix Sin and Sidecar together and apply it on the center of my lids to give it a little bit of light, but it's not gonna be too much. I'm gonna use the Japanese liner again. You can either use whatever your favorite black liner, but I'm gonna use the K Palette One Day Tattoo liner in the color number 1, which is like the blackest black. The shape is gonna be something really thin in the beginning, and then it's gonna wing out really. You can go thicker than this, but I find that the shape would work for me already. So I get the shape that I like. We're just gonna let that dry a bit and go work on our brows. Today I'm using the Cosmo Slim Brow Pencil in Deep Brown. It's like, this is a new one. I just cracked this one open because I just ran out of the other one. And we're just gonna go a little bit more like archy than normal, just because it's what she went for. This is a trick that I've been doing recently. I kind of focus on the beginning of the brows using the upward motion instead of going on the side, because the hair of your brows are going that way. You can definitely go darker than this if you want, because the look, like very, very dark brows, but I just find that it's gonna look really scary on me. I'm actually gonna darken my brows using the brow mascara instead of using the powder. So I'm using the L'Oreal Brow Artist Plumper in the darker one. I'm gonna use a smaller brush to mix Bug and Sidecar together to use on the lower lash lines. So I don't see much on her lower lash lines, but there's still some sort of a color and a little bit of sparkle. And I'm gonna curl my lashes and then apply falsies, choosing one of the biggest falsies I have. Okay, this is a Lush Lash, but it's a new unreleased number that I'm gonna use before anybody else. I've been using this one like in all events and everybody's just like, oh my god, the lashes. I'm sorry, I cannot tell you the number. Soon, very soon. Using the Maybelline Cat Eye Mascara on the lower lash lines. But this mascara is getting sticky. Okay, everything is good. I'm gonna give my face a little chisel define using Kevin Aucoin Sculpting Powder in medium. Lightly contour. If you don't have this problem, if you have like a pretty small face already, kind of skip this step. I know that sometimes like some Thai girls have been watching me for so long, they think they need every single step, but makeup is just not like that. You do you, okay? So if you have a small V-shaped face already, you might not need a couple of steps that I do, but I just like, I think I have a round face. That's why I need to contour. I'm like psycho like that. Change the brush a bit and then contour my nose. Because I feel like we're gonna go pretty crazy afterward. So might as well just do it. Do it. I like this pair of lashes on me. The bronzer I'm using today is Tarte Park Ave Princess Bronzer from Tarte. I'm gonna use a big MAC brush. This is a 138. I have a patchy tan, I'm sorry if you see that. If I haven't pointed out, somebody might not see, but can you see that like this is lighter than the rest? It's been like bugging me for the whole day and I'm like, This is just like glowy, happy, and not too dark. I like bronzers that are not too pigmented because you can build it up and build it up. Some of the bronzers are so pigmented that you have to be like very careful, you know, just like, and then you like, it doesn't blend. It's like this big patch of bronzer right here. And then I'm gonna apply blush right away using Hourglass Dim Infusion Ambient Lighting Blush with my blush brush. Keep challenging myself with some words. I don't know why. It's more of a peachy blush because I don't want to be putting some pink on. We're more trying to keep it tan and neutral because you're gonna see what's going on afterwards. What can I say? It's not too glowy in the music video. Okay, now we have a little bit of a glow going on. To the next level. I'm using, for my lips, I'm gonna start by using Me. It's a Thai brand, I think, but it's made in Korea. Is it Thai? They send me this eyeliner and I find it's really nice and it's still not coming off my hand. This is Me Underline 9 Seconds Auto Pencil Eyeliner, but it's an auto pencil. What we're gonna do is we're gonna line our lips. Your best friend is a Q-tip. And if you make more mistakes, I just like I'm just gonna talk like this for another 5 minutes just because I like that I scare the heck out of you. If you make mistakes, you can really use concealer to erase your mistake. And the lipstick that I'm using right in the middle is this one from Urban Decay. I'm not sure if it's limited or not, but it came out with that Pulp Fiction collection. Urban Decay lipstick in Mrs. Mia Wallace, which is a deep red like this. And I'm gonna use a lip brush with it. This is a Anna Sui brush. Try not to touch that black quite just yet. We'll blend it out. But right now, if you touch it too much, your lipstick is gonna be blotchy and not quite red in the middle. Okay, now that I have a lot of red going on, I'm gonna start blending. I have a tissue in front of me to kind of wipe my brush off. Right now, we're gonna go over the black. This is not gonna come out looking like this. This is Rita though. She did this, but I know that this is gonna be too much for a lot of you, so I'm just gonna go over the black. That means you're still gonna have the black as a base. So it's still gonna look pretty intense. Last but not least, I'm gonna finish the whole face with the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder and Diffused Light. I have been coming back to this powder and use it all over the face. I find that it gives a really nice sheen to the face without looking too shiny. It keeps like being more and more glowy the longer you wear it. It's not too white as well, and I'm gonna finish everything with the Urban Decay. Like, I'm not gonna wash this makeup off. So that concludes the Rita Ora from Body On Me music video with Chris Brown. I love this look. I saw it and I was just like, oh, brings out the Shola in me, that I used to have a darker lip liner and a lighter lip color when I was growing up, which we're not gonna go see those pictures ever. I burned them all. But I mean, it's out there and I think it's fun. For those of you who wanna try something fun, I think you're gonna like this look. You can definitely use this whole makeup with other lip colors. You can just go ahead, have fun. So I hope you guys enjoy another one of our English episode. And if you like to see other looks, just give me a request and I'll make them for you guys. So I'll see you again. Bye.